Hi fellow stampers, my name is Laurie Meyer. I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, and I also have a blog at stampedgreetings.com. This month I'm participating in the North Carolina Demos Blog Hop. We're celebrating spring holidays and spring occasions, and each of us is featuring a project. I really hope that you join us on the blog hop and look at everybody's amazing designs. I focused on putting a Mother's Day card together, and I used several of the images from Tea Together and a technique that I'm sure many of you have used before, a masking technique. I thought it would be so much easier to show you how I put the design together rather than write out the directions. So that's why I decided to put this quick video together for the blog. Let me show you in just a few steps how you can make this design really quickly. And especially if you have the Stamparatus. This is an amazing tool. It is a stamp positioner that allows you to have many different stamps, and you can easily flip the plates on either the side or the top so that you can have a lot of different stamps readily available for you to use. And I'm telling you, mass production is super simple with this. The first thing that you're going to do for this project is create a mask. And when you create a mask and you're putting together a card with a masking technique, you want to look at the image that is going to be in the forefront of your design and the image that is going to show in its entirety. Well, that's the teacup and saucer. So I'm going to create a mask for that teacup and saucer stamp. I'm using the beautiful, unfortunately retiring, Tranquil Tide ink. This is one of my favorites, and I'm going to be very sad to see it go. But what I'm going to do, and you can see this is an old design as far as the stamp case, forgive me, but I tend to use things before they dry up, especially with inks. And all I'm going to do here is stamp that image, and I've put a post-it note on the Stamparatus, and I'm just stamping that image. Post-it notes are super handy because they have that nice little adhesive at the top. And what I'm going to do with that stamped post-it note is I'm going to cut out my mask. For those of you who may be groaning, thinking, oh my goodness, we're talking fussy cutting. Yeah, but really not that much. All you really need to cut out are the parts of the image that are going to overlap where that teapot is in the design. So it's not a whole heck of a lot. So trust me, this will only take a couple of minutes. Few things to point out when you make a mask. One is use the thinnest paper you can. Either a post-it note or even copy paper is something that I really like to use. And also, when you cut out your mask, get as close to the line as you can on the actual image that you're cutting out. The reason for that is, when I stamp the teapot, which we're going to do in just a minute, that image is going to come right up to the edge of the teacup. If I have thick paper, I'm going to get a little bit of a lip. There might be a white area showing. And I want that the teapot design to get as close to the teacup as I can make it. And also, when I cut on the line, the image that I'm going to be stamping over that mask is also going to more likely look like it's really right behind because it's going to cozy up to that image on the front. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to stamp the teacup and saucer. And because I had positioned the stamp on my Stamparatus, I'm not going to be moving it. I'm just going to stamp it onto my Whisper White cardstock. And that is cut to 4 1/8 by 5 3/8 because I want it to be just a little bit narrower than my card base, which is going to be a traditional A2. Now, yes, I did take time to put all the stamps onto my Stamparatus, and you will do that as well. It's very straightforward. So you can see that I put my teacup stamp in the bottom right-hand corner. Well, now I want to mask that off. So I'm simply going to take the post-it note that I stamped on, and I'm going to place that right over the image of my teacup and saucer. Then I'm going to ink up the teapot, and yep, I did place this in my Stamparatus earlier, and I made sure that it was going to be in the place that I wanted it. And you can see that I'm overlapping that image, but the bottom part of the teapot is not going to show on our final design because we have that mask. Now, you probably want to see what it looks like with the teapot stamped, but wait just a minute, because one other thing we're going to stamp before we take the mask off is the large flower image from the Tea Together stamp set. And again, you're going to notice that that visually looks like it is on the teapot, and the big flower is sort of being hidden by that teacup. We want to leave the mask where it is. And here's one beauty of the Stamparatus. All I'm going to do is take that plate off, flip it around, and now I can stamp the large flower. Again, I'm using Tranquil Tide. I'm putting that onto my image and stamping that. And you're going to see that the mask has captured a part of the flower and a part of the leaves. That's fine, because we want it to look like it is behind the teacup. The final stamp that we're going to use is the small rosebud stamp. And we want to put that on the teacup. So we do want to take the mask off. This is where I'm envisioning that you're going to say, ooh, doesn't that look amazing? And ooh, doesn't that look amazing? It looks like the teapot is behind the teacup and saucer. Again, the magic of the Stamparatus. I've already put the flower stamp on the plate. I'm going to ink that again with Tranquil Tide. And what's kind of neat about the teacup and saucer stamp is it has this hole. So it was super convenient that I'm able to put my finger in the middle of that stamp and stamp on the rosebuds. Now you can really do the ooh and ah, because isn't that amazing? And what's also amazing is I have everything set up on the Stamparatus, so I can do the exact same card again. And the beauty is that the mask that I used to make this card can be used again. Just be careful when you reuse the mask. Every once in a while, flip it over and make sure that there's no ink that is bleeding through on the opposite side. That's your clue that this mask is done and you need to create another one. You definitely don't want ink from the mask bleeding onto the image. That's it. That's how simple this is. I really hope that you give this a try. What you may find is that you want to add a little bit of color to your final design. Super easy. What I did is I used a couple of different colors. I used the garden green for the leaves, and I used the berry burst for the flowers. And believe it or not, I actually aqua painted these on using my aqua painters. And even though it's whisper white cardstock and not watercolor paper, if you use just a little bit of the ink, you're going to get an amazing, amazing image. The final thing that I did before I put the card on my card base is I got out my Simply Scoring tool and I put a couple of score lines right at the edge of the image, and I did that on all four corners. You'll be amazed if you haven't used this technique of how much of a classy finish you can get by simply putting score lines on the side of your focal point. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I really hope that you will give this design a try. These are two cards that I made with the exact setup that you see, and you saw how quick it is. So grab your Stamparatus, grab your Tea Together stamp set, and make some beautiful Mother's Day cards. Thanks. Hope to see you again soon. Happy stamping.